in the process as the announcement was coming. Like I said, they've been receptive. If you think about it, and I had to explain it to our commissioners this way, which is, what is the development agreement, in essence? What is it? Well, we have infrastructure that they're going to come invest millions in to provide an infrastructure that isn't here now. And they're going to invest millions of dollars in our community to make our community better. If you think about it like that, this isn't, we're giving an incentive, this isn't a tax abatement deal, this isn't star bonds, or any of the things that you see out here, it's just, it's different. And so, to date, we haven't had any telecommunications issue. We don't foresee any telecommunications issue. We think it's more of a partnership than a competition. And I think Google and the telecommunication providers are in that same vein. To answer your specific questions, I couldn't answer those.
That's fair.
What about providers choking off bandwidth on net neutrality? Why would you want to get mixed up with that?
I thought we were going to have technology. I can tell you about taxes. This, quite honestly, it's not something that I can comment on anymore.
Well, I mean, I don't think it's any secret. I mean, publicly, that Google is a big proponent of net neutrality. And believe in the idea of an open network. I mean, they've been very, and that's, you know, that's not news to anybody. Part of that, I think they are engaged with the city and with the state and becoming a very good partner. And that is very important to them. And so they're looking to work with the cities and the states to address those issues. And I've never seen anything to them out yet.
But how are they looking to deal with Time Warner Cable or Comcast?
We can't probably do it. And honestly, I don't think that helps.
Yeah, that's one of our biggest challenges and opportunities, quite honestly. Is we think the line of technology is widening the gap of the haves versus the have-nots. And for our community, with the education levels, the amount of distress that we actually have, we see that widening. It's already widening without Google. How do we take Google to minimize that gap? And I think a major component in this that people have overlooked is that the city of Kansas City, Kansas, Kansas City, Missouri, both spent a whole lot of time and a whole lot of effort on making sure that we have free installation and service at schools and other community assets. We have 130 in our agreement, I don't remember what you have in your agreement. We think using that, especially in the impoverished areas where people may not have a laptop, may not be able to provide the services when it's paid for, because it's not free. How do we engage them? And we're particularly looking at community centers, churches, schools, government businesses, you know, government entities, and how do you cross that line? And it's going to have to be ingrained in the school system, and a whole lot of work is going to have to be done socially to get people caught up. And Google provided.
I guess I'm more concerned about someone who has had trouble keeping their home, someone coming in from the outside and saying, I'm going to pay the water price for your house and the name of the go. There's only so much land and so many places to go.
You know, quite honestly, A, you haven't thought about that problem, and B, I don't envision that. I just don't. I don't think the demand would be needed.
And we've focused a lot of our stimulus funding there, and we was very interested in that neighborhood. It's an underserved neighborhood, and they have told us they're interested in building out that area. So they really, in our conversations, want to see what will happen when everyone has access to the web. So they're thinking in those lines, and the school district is very involved. And we have 300 facilities in our agreement. We don't get the free hookup, but we get the free service.
So